when someone solves the previous year paper, okay, I personally, you know what I did? When I solved previous year paper, I do this for Max, okay? Biology, I was good, so I never felt this. But Max, everything, I couldn't answer the single paper in the question paper. Okay, meaning the question past year papers at home. I couldn't solve a single question. You know what I used to do? Throw the paper in the dustbin, that's it. Yeah, honestly, I did this, okay? In 10th standard, I used to throw the paper. I'll be like, I'm not solving this next paper. Whichever is easy, I solve that paper, not the hard paper. But when I went to college, I understood one thing. That every question is a, I don't know, like if you're going to tuitions, you might know this. But for those who didn't go to tuitions like me, they should know that, you know, every question in the question previous years is a potential question. So what you can do is instead have a notebook or, you know, just in the, you have those questions in the question paper itself, solve those questions, see and solve it, no problem. Even if it is hard, see and solve it and then go back to those questions and again solve everything. Okay, and see if you remember. So you will understand the pattern and something like that if comes, something near to that if it comes, you know what to answer. If you're very lucky, it might, okay? Honestly, I got 3-4 questions like that from previous papers. So, this is what I'm telling you, okay? Don't panic, don't throw the paper or don't be like, okay, next, no. Okay, solve that, be patient, that is very important. You need patience for everything. Even when you go to college, you might score very less, okay? Because people, you remember, people tell you that 10th to 11th, you have a transition phase. 12th to college, you have a transition phase. Where everything changes, your marks go down and that's normal, that's not normal, okay, that's not normal. Why does it, than the 12th boards, my college exams were easy. 12th boards were, I literally scratched my head like a crazy girl, okay. But college exams, I was eating chole puri, I was eating paratha, I was cooking, I was doing everything and nicely writing the exam. That much cool I was, but the only problem was I was depressed. I was not happy. So there are so many adult life problems that land to your head. Even in 10th to 11th, you think that you're in student life, but still parental expectations. And then some people might come to the course unwillingly. Yeah, maybe you don't, some people might not understand what the seriousness and just landed to that doubt. Like, I have no idea, so I'm going to biomath. Please, before going to biomath, think twice. Okay, I'm telling you, honestly, you'll be like, biomath, I don't have any idea, so I'm going to biomath. First, know what is your ability. It's not necessary that you should know everything. You are not Tenali Rama or Bhaskaracharya and all, okay? You are normal humans and know your ability and go to that. Think before, okay? So, that is important. Don't just go like that and suffer and, drop down your grades in everything. You try to focus on what you're weak and you leave what you're strong at. This is what happens. This happened with me. That's why I'm telling you so that you don't make those mistakes. Okay? So, yeah. So, this transition phase is very important. So, unwillingly don't go and all these transition, this when your adult life extra problems come to your brain, your score goes down. So, try to solve those extra problems first and then start studying. So, I hope this is the best way to get good marks. I would tell this. Okay? So, try to tackle it as soon as possible and start studying well. I hope it helped you a lot and I hope you people were not bored with all these things. And these are some things, your mental health, your personal priority is more important. Don't get lost. Yeah, it's fine if you score less, doesn't mean that you should not work hard. It's fine if you score less, meaning after working hard, we don't know what we will get.
Could you just read out what is written?
Yeah. So, be patient in solving question papers, like I said. And then, choose the stream only if you are capable to. Okay? Either you should be an expert in it, or if you're forced, you should have high endurance and will. Okay? And then, nothing is worthy as your happiness and mental peace. This is the fact. If you're gonna stress into everything, then you are gonna land into depression forever. Okay? So, don't stress. Enjoy the moments you have. Laugh, make jokes, crack jokes, stupid jokes, whatever jokes you want, crack. Okay? And enjoy, but also have balance. And then focus at one thing. This is very important. Focus on one thing at a time. Okay? For example, when I was in 12th, I scored 45 in chemistry out of 70. My chemistry ma'am was like, Sandhri, you scored really good in 11th. After one of the boys said, I came 3 months late to 11th. Okay, 3 months late, and I came exactly. I even remember, Rati ma'am, I failed in computer in the first test. She was like, it's okay. I started crying and she was like, it's okay, it's fine. And I was in sixth standard, I failed. So, because I came and there was a computer test. I knew nothing about computer and very bad at computer, I accepted. I'm so sorry. It's my weakness, but my sister is really good at computer. So, this is very important, okay? So, focus at one thing at a time. I came 3 months late and I started IELTS practice, ACT, SAT, NEET, whatnot. I started everything, okay? And I couldn't focus for board exams and the exams and that. So, my organic chemistry became weak. Because organic chemistry needs understanding and practice. Yeah? You cannot just close your eyes, I got organic chemistry, no. Okay? So, you need to write, maintain a note. You have to practice again and again, understand the concepts and questions can be in any way. Yeah, so my organic chemistry became weak and all the sums in chemistry became very weak. I got 45. I didn't even remember the equations in exam. So what I did, I left HCT, I threw SAT, I threw everything in the dustbin and I sat for 1 month. I only studied chemistry, organic chemistry. I only focused on that. I took a note. My good quality is that if I don't understand something, I become so stubborn to understand it. Okay, and I somehow or the other I understand it. Okay, that is and I remember it for lifetime. And whatever you learn is not gonna go waste. I assure you that. And if you feel stressed, not for the ones who always play and enjoy, for the ones who always study, if you feel stressed, take break. I would tell you, take a break. If it's 1 day, 1 week, no problem. Your brain needs rejuvenation. If you don't take break, being a medical student, I'm telling you, if you don't take break, you're gonna get tired at the wrong time. Exams or somewhere, so always take breaks. If you feel that you're depressed, it's taking a toll on you, one day sit, sleep nicely, watch movies, hear music, one day, and the next day, start studying. Okay? But it should not be too long for 1 month, okay? Don't tell your parents that Soundarya told take break for 1 month and you're taking one break and I'll get beatings from everyone. So, start from day one. I hope you heard this for a long time, yeah? From everyone. And then, work hard at all circumstances. Never give up, okay? Never ever give up. Sometimes you will not get what you deserve at that moment. But don't give up, okay? Still work hard. Somewhere or the other, it will pay off. Like, even in my life, I never got what I wanted or this is not my dream college. But still, I'm happy in this college. Everyone admires me for what knowledge I have. Everyone, even if they don't talk, they know to whom to ask doubt to. Okay, they know that Soundarya is the only person who will explain very well than the professor. And they'll come here and they'll be like, Soundarya, can you explain me this whole chapter? And I'm very happy to explain because I'm gonna by heart the second time, you know, it's an advantage for me. So I'm gonna do that. And NCERT is Gita of CBSE. NCERT is Bible of CBSE. Always don't skip your NCERT. I've seen lot of, I've seen new NCERT books, okay? I don't want that to happen. At least open your NCERT books once and try to read what is there inside that, please. Please, very much please, okay? Please do that. And practice is the key. You might know that. And it's okay to break down for 1 day. Stay neutral, as I said. And first priority, health, food and sleep. For those who study tirelessly, like who are not for the ones, okay? I'm talking about the ones who work very, very hard, overly hard. Please take time for your health also, okay? Honestly, when I went to medicine, I saw 90% of the disease was due to physical exercise. Honestly, you will not believe me. It sounds a very complicated disease, but finally they will put that the cause is lack of inactivity. Physical inactivity is the cause. I'm like, and why do they have such weird names for that? They have so many weird names, but at the end of the day, the cause is inactivity. Physical inactivity or genetics, that's it. So, I suggest you please, please, please do some physical activity. Like walk for 40 minutes, it's fine. Nothing, you are not gonna achieve Bharat Ratna in 40 minutes, okay? You can walk in 40 minutes, it's fine. Nothing is gonna happen. And food and sleep. Have 8 hours, at least 6 hours of sleep properly. Because sacrificing your sleep, you're gonna compromise with your efficiency. And write and learn. I'm not, everyone has a different learning strategy, but those who have that much of patience and concentration, write and learn.